This is Beth's Weight Watchers eTools instructional video on how to input a food into the online tracker, specifically a food that is not listed in the Weight Watchers database. So this would be a food that you, a specific brand that you are putting in there that Weight Watchers doesn't already have in there. So I'm on the main page, I'm already logged in, and as you can see, the upper left-hand corner is the Weight Watchers eTools emblem. So I'm going to scroll down to the left-hand side to the points tracker. And if you're already on the points tracker, then just hang on till I get there. And you're going to hit the points tracker, and it should come up in another window if you don't already have it. And I actually have mine up already, so I'm going to close the window I was on before. So you should have, it should say Weight Watchers Plan Manager in the upper left-hand corner. And points tracker is highlighted. If that's not, click on it to get into the points tracker. So this is, again, if you've already searched in your food tracker, you put in something and you're very specific about the brand and it doesn't come up and you can't find anything that works with it. Well, you can put it in yourself, just like if you use your normal little slide rule that they give you in the back of your little gold booklet, then this is just it's kind of its own little calculator. So here's our own little calculator here, and you can see the food points value. And I'm going to put in a Clif Bar, a specific Clif Bar that I like to eat. So I'm going to go ahead and put in the calories just like you normally would with the slider. Put in the fat content and put in the fiber content. Okay? Now I'm going to hit the button calculate, and notice how it comes up and says equals 5. Now the cool thing is, if you don't want to put it into your tracker, you can go ahead and you're putting it on the paper tracker, then you can just, you know, it's told you that it's 5, so you can go ahead and write it in if you want. If you are putting this into your online tracker, which is the kind of the goal of this video, then there are two options at this point. You can either move over to this bottom part where it says already know the points value of food, add the food here. Now I would recommend using this if you already know, okay, this is something that I'm just having once, I likely won't have it again, or if I do, it's, you know, it's not something I'm going to have on a regular basis, then this might be what you want to put in. So I'm going to go ahead and put in points value of 5. Food optional, I'm going to put Clif Test, because I think I already have Clif Bar in there. Now it says optional. If you are in a hurry and you know, oh, I ate 5 points, you can put 5 points in. You don't have to put a food in, and it will still put it into your tracker. It just won't list what the food is. So let's say I had that, I'm going to say anytime, like I had it in the afternoon or something like that, and I hit add. And if I scroll down on my tracker, you can see that it says Clif Test Quick Added Food. And that just means I didn't save it. It's not in my favorites. It's not in the Weight Watchers database. It's something that I just went ahead and put in real quickly, and just so that I know I had it and it's in there. And of course, as always, notice how your daily use popped up to 5 and your daily remaining went down to 18. So it's still calculating this as you go along. The other option, let's say you're like, okay, that's great, but I actually am really into Clif Bars. I'm deciding I really like them, so I'm probably going to have this on a regular basis, and I don't want to have to put it in every time. Well, you can actually save this to favorites, and the way you do that is you put your information in as we did, hit calculate, and we already did that. It's still got that same 5 point saved on there. And at the bottom, I'm going to hit add to tracker. Now, if I hit this button instead of going over to the right and putting it into the quick added area, then it will ask me to save it as a favorite foods and stuff. So it's kind of good to know this. So I hit add to tracker, and a new box will pop up, and it'll say create new food. So I'm going to type in Clif Test up here, and then I'm going to hit make this a favorite, and then the next line talks about the different nutritional content, and of course the nutritional content is right because I already put it into my calculator, but it's for some reason it's kind of just giving you a chance to adjust it if you need to. And one serving, what happens here is I am going to have one serving, but let's say that I normally let's say that the calories and whatnot that I inputted would be, or let's, or actually back up. Let's say that I put this in, but I know that I'm going to have two Clif bars. Now, hopefully not, but it, let's say that's normal for me to have two at once instead of one. I could change this to a two, and my points value would pop up. Now, why would you do that? Well, if you know that every time you eat this, pretty much you're going to be eating the same, you're going to be eating two at once instead of one, then putting this in this way will help you. It'll just be a quicker way. It'll automatically be saved that way. It doesn't mean you can't change it back to one when you do input it, but it already pops up that way. So I'm going to go back and change it to one because I know I'm only going to need one. There's a note section, so if you, for some reason, had some notes you wanted or something you wanted to remember about it, you could put that there. And then down in the bottom right, you hit create food. Give it a second, because sometimes it takes a little bit of time to pop up, and occasionally it doesn't pop up. I'd say 9/10 of the time it pops up for me. That extra 10th, if you wait a few minutes and it still doesn't pop up, then just go back and then put it into the calculator on the left. So now it says add food. So it says your food has been created. Would you like to add it to your tracker? So now what it's telling you is it's been created, it's saved into your favorites. But now the idea is you probably, because you put it in, want to actually put it in your tracker. So what you can do now is you can do one of two things. You can either hit cancel if it's a food that you just wanted to store in your favorites but you didn't want to actually say you've eaten it. Or you can go ahead and say, yes, I had one serving. It's morning, and or I'm having it anytime, whenever it is, the date is today, and add to tracker. And so then once again, you can see that your daily use is 10 and your daily remaining is 13. And also down here, you can see that it also tells you your daily use is 10 and your daily remaining is 13. So this is just a good way, because not everything is in the database for Weight Watchers. So if you need to input a food, you have two options. Use the calculator for both, but one option is to go down here and to just quickly add it, which means it won't save to your favorites, and the other is to input it and then actually go through the saving process. Saving to favorites is cool because say I this is tomorrow and I want to put Clif test, I want to eat it again. If I put Clif test in, hit go, lo and behold, notice how it pops up, right? And I've got two in here because I've actually done a different test, but it pops up. And so it is saved in my favorites, and so I don't ever have to go through that whole thing of entering the nutritional information. So thanks for listening, and hope it was informative. Now with this and the basic online tracker, you should have enough tools for how to enter foods into your online tracker. And don't be afraid to try things, because if you mess up, you can always go to the little boxes, click the boxes, go down to delete, and they go away. So you can always change things. It's never set in stone. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you next time.